Today we're going to talk about the Cask Widge. I've been using one of these for a couple of years, and when I caught up with Brewgoat, today's sponsor, I'm a co-owner in the Swedish homebrew supplier Brewgoat. I convinced one of the other owners, Michael, by locking him into a small cellar without food or water for 3 days. He obviously had beer, but yeah, when it came out, he promised me that we were going to sell those. And yeah, this ain't the only floater on the market. This is a floating beer pickup, and I have tried two others as well. All good working, but yeah, you get it. I fancy this one, and that's why I forced little Michael into the cellar. With that said, let's get naked. I'm DrHans, this is DrHans Brewery, my channel about beer and homebrewing. So if you want to learn with me how to become better at beer and brewing, consider becoming a subscriber. Yeah, do hit that little bell so you get notification when I put out a new video. And thumbs up this video and share it with your friends and family. Let's get this party started. Michael have promised me... I broke it. Michael have promised me a table for when doing like these kind of videos. I don't see a table, do you? Nice! This is the cereal beer, the start beer. This turned out amazing. I didn't even know if it's gonna turn out to be beer in the end, but it did. Check out the video, I will link to that down below. Also, of course, linked to today's sponsor, Brewgoat. Let's talk about them a little more in a while. The reason why I got this sent in from a viewer was that I had a small problem, and then I found out how actually cool it was. This one I bought before, and I've used this in the keg. I'm gonna talk about that also, but let's start off with the cask widge. And of course, this one, this is gonna be messy, guys. When editing this video, I found that I actually forgot to tell you why someone would like to invest in a floating pickup in the first place. Beer clears from the top because of gravity. Of course, yeast are settling down and proteins and so on. So with a floating pickup, you will always draw the clearest beer when you pour yourself a pint. It's not more complicated than that. Let's go back to the doctor. When I started fermenting in the Fermentasaurus, I had a small problem. When I was dry hopping, I couldn't take an SG sample from the beer without getting hops sucked up when I was dry hopping. Otherwise, there were no issues at all. Of course, you could like throw a tilt in there, but yeah, do remember that the tilt will get affected by the pressure, but of course, it's still a good alternative to get to know when you have a stable gravity in your beer. He's a bit shy, but he called himself John Smith, aka Hophead. Thank you very much. But of course, everyone doesn't have the opportunity to just get sent stuff for free. It's a maracas also. This ain't, so it doubles as a maracas. This ain't expensive, and now it's available also here in Sweden, or yeah, Brugo chips like everywhere. So yeah, the cask widge, just like the ball, is a floating pickup, but with the filter on it. And if we're looking at the clear beer draft system, I want to make a big shout out to my patron for helping out and my new channel members. And of course, today's sponsor, Brewgoat, which likes to send you a message that they are now taking pre-orders on the Spandit 2.0. And of course, that's my fault also, because I have been using the first Spandit for a couple of years. What I had to do to get Michael to send Spandit 2.0, that's for another video. But yeah, if you're interested in that, go and check it out. We'll link down below to the cask widge and also to the Spandit pre-order page. Yes. Okay. It's caught with a ball. This comes with the Fermentasaurus, the Fermenter King, the Fermzillas, and of course, this will fit the Fermentasaurus, the Fermzillas, and yeah, we're gonna talk about the kegs also. Because this one I bought for kegs. This is a like over-engineered monster. And this is very expensive, but if you want everything like stainless, go for this one. It costs a lot of money, it works great. It works just as good as this one. It's a lovely over-engineered piece of equipment, but it is very expensive. And the filter is an add-on also, so you need to buy that. When I first saw the ball with the Fermentasaurus, it was just genius, because this is a genius product when I saw this, but the simplicity of the ball is excellent. And in the middle of this comes the cask widge. It has the filter inside of it, and also like the simplicity of the ball. But this is a plastic device, so think about that what you want to. So this little thing took that problem that I had with my Fermentasaurus when dry hopping. If you don't need to take an SG reading when you have dry hops in there, you can just cool crash it and this will work fine. Sometimes it do picks up a little bit pieces, so I do prefer this one, but I often just use this if I don't know that I really want to like take an SG sample during dry hopping. My main concern with this one was that cleaning it, would it cause any problems? John Smith, aka Hophead, ensured me that they have been using this on his pub for years for casks, and they never had a problem. And I never had a problem either. I clean it by back flushing it. And just before this video, to give you some better information, I try to soak this in boiling water without any issues. There won't be an issue with these two either, of course, because they are stainless. I also use the cask widge in a keg, and of course this one, because that's why I bought it. I haven't tried this one in a keg, but of course it will obviously work just as fine. What you have to do is to change out the long dip tube for a small gas tube. So you have to have two gas tubes in there, and instead of the dip tube, you will put a hose and the cask widge or the other ones, and use that instead. You do want really to try out the length of the hose. My experience tells me that it is a little bit shorter than you would want with the ball. So do try that out really with a small amount of water in the bottom, so you get a feel for the length you need to get. This is quite a good length. Should I measure that for your convenience? I will measure the length of the snub nose. Should be the same with the Fermentasaurus and the Fermenter King. This worked fine for me, and that's 51 centimeters. I don't have the length for everything else. I didn't plan this, it was just something I thought about now. Sorry about that. Let me jump back here again. Let me try to show you how to fit this into a keg. Or how much you can really see in there. So we have two short gas lines instead of the long pickup tube. This is easily removed, and just pull the dip tube up and insert the shorter one instead. And here we have another cask widge, and we have a hose. And different kegs have different heights, so no need to measure this one, but I can show you how it lays when it goes down into the bottom. One end, of course, goes on here. And rest, drop that into the keg. And attach this on the beer side. If it's tight, just dip the hose for a while in scorching hot water, but that worked like a treat. I can see here that this is actually a little bit too long. I need it to like get flat on the bottom. We don't have to cut this much, but just a little. When you do trim this in, you want to cut in small increments, because a little goes a long way. Took off like 1.5 centimeters. That's roughly 1/2 inch. Nope, could do a little more. Then of course, you know this, how this will end. I will cut too much. Yep. Now it's too short. Okay, got a longer hose. Hope this. It's a little bit tighter. This could be tricky. Have some hot water. I got this hose from Michael, so if this is tricky, it's his fault, of course. Let's try it. It's not that much hard, really, than putting a rubber on a donkey. I think we all can relate to that. Okay, now that's on there. And this was a longer one, so need to shorten this down, but not too much. You do want to pay attention here so you get the most beer possible out of your keg. So, little by little, put the hose back on. It's not that bad. I will risk it. Just for you guys. Put the hose back on. A reason that I want to get this very snug is that I'm gonna try. If you stick to the end, I will tell you the result of it already. I will try actually to do a close transfer through this. Of course, that means that I'm gonna get some particles on the inside of the filter, but that should be pushed up with the first draw of the keg anyways. So I will try that. Okay, we ain't getting any better than that, really. I think that's as low as I will get it. We're almost at the bottom there. So try to trim it in as good as possible. Having a floating pickup in your keg also means that you could actually prime and naturally carbonate the beer in your keg and don't pick up the sediment until the floater hits the bottom and the keg is done. And that means that you could, if you want to do like dry hopping or anything, or naturally carbonate your beer, you could too early from your whatever bucket, whatever you're using, transfer it into the keg and close off the keg and put a spunding valve on the keg and let it carbonate naturally. And that will also reduce the oxygen of your beer. And if you're dry hopping that way, it means that you'll have a longer shelf life. Because, yeah, your beer won't get oxygenated because there are still a lot of activity. That means that you, of course, have to transfer the beer before the fermentation is over. It's starting to rain now. When you see the fermentation dropping, you could actually moving the beer over into the keg and let it carbonate up naturally with a spawning valve, and you could dry hop at that stage. That would be a good tip. Back to the doctor for more tips what to do with a floating pickup. Yeah. If you have the clear beer draft system already and you're just gonna use it for kegging, I wouldn't change it out because, yeah, this works just fine. But I wouldn't want to put like this one into a plastic fermenter. Then I would use the cask widge. You could, like, of course, MacGyver something up. With a ball to make your own filter, but yeah, this is super cheap, and you could of course like MacGyver up the entire thing, but sometimes it just feels good to buy something and move on. And the cask widge actually also fits in like this mini kegs where the ball don't get in there, and obviously not the clear beer draft system. If we put the ball aside and talk about cool things you can do with a floating pickups with a filter on them. This may be cheating, but this is what I got right now to work with. The Fermenter King Junior. So it's not so much beer in it. So this will be good, I think. Someone has stolen some beer there. I bet it was Michael. So we're gonna do a close transfer from the Fermenter King Junior into the keg. We attach the spandit and let's release some pressure. And we are now going through the cask Widge. So this might foam up, but I'm thinking we have more headspace in this. This holds like 20 liters and this is 18 liters, but there's some headspace here. Beer is moving. Is this good content? I have a better video about this, but here we can see it again. Beer coming out into the keg. Gas coming in into the fermenter. So we're transferring under pressure. And gas will escape through the fermenter. This is Jukkes, the Welsh beer we brewed over at Brew Goat. And I could have just have served from the fermenter. You saw someone has stolen some there. But actually, I want the yeast this time. So I will transfer it to the keg instead. And we will use the yeast for an American wheat. Beer is moving quite rapidly. So there is a chance that it will foam up, but if you have a transparent keg like this one, you will actually see what's happening inside, and then you know exactly how fast you can move it. I have a better video on this, so I will link down below to that so you can go and check it out, when I used the Fermenter King Jr. as a keg and I did a close transfer from, I think it was a Fermzilla, to the Fermenter King Jr. and I really pushed it. Nice video, if I may have, if I can say so myself, sorry. Back in a flash when I have some more interesting things to report. For now, back to the doctor and I will report back in a bit how this went, okay? If we put the ball aside and talk about cool things you can do with a floating pickup with a filter on them. Both of them. If kegging, if you want to dry hop in the keg, if you want to add a lot of like fruits in your keg or fermenter, or if you want to go crazy with like oats and whatever, you could just go nuts and use one of these and they will not clog up your line. So that's awesome. I heard someone having problems with I think it was the clear bay draft system, but it could happen to any one of them, where they start floating on top of like the debris layer, if you say that, if you have a lot of like if you have a lot of oaks bits, or if you have a lot of hops. If that should happen, you're starting to see that you are just drawing CO2, just give it a little shake and yeah, you should be fine again. It haven't happened to me, but I heard it happened to other people. And if it happens to this one, it was obviously could happen to this one. And the ball, but you won't be using the ball in that matter. Okay, this has been going flawlessly. We're up to, I don't know if you can see anything. I will soon shut this off. I will show you. Where's my spray bottle? Disconnect everything. Disconnect the spandit. Make noise. Disconnect the beer line. So that went flawlessly. So you could do that. Push the beer through the cask Widge. But there is another alternative, and that is to change out the lid for a lid with a post. So we could have the dip tube left in place. So we would have gas in, beer in through the dip tube, and beer out through the lid with the post and the hose and the cask lid was sitting on the lid. That would be the perfect keg for this. And as soon as I get a lid from Michael, a Brew Goat, we'll try to build the perfect keg. Nice. Back to the doctor outside in the sun. Today it's raining here. So if you want to take an SG sample when fermenting under pressure, this is a good idea. And also, if you want to go like crazy with adding fruits or adding like leaf hops also, and oats bits, whatever you want to throw in there, vanilla pods, get crazy. Use a filter. If you're a stainless guy and like to spend money, I do. I think actually I have two of these and they work great, but I wouldn't put them in a plastic fermenter. So if you're fermenting under pressure and or like to play around with stuff in your kegs, go and get a floating pickup. And if you're not fermenting under pressure, start with that. You won't look back. I promise you that. Here you can see the cask widge sitting nicely along the side here. This is an American wheat, which I obviously just brewed up. So this will ferment now. I have a lot of cleaning to do, but just wanted to cut this in here so you can see it in action in the fermenter. So guys, if you haven't already, consider becoming a subscriber. Do hit that little bell to get notifications when I put out a new video. Like this video, share it with friends and family. And of course, as always, thanks for watching. DrHans out.